NATO has over the past days appeared on several media platforms showing its leaders and those of affiliated trade unions in bitter exchange of words. The current conflict stems from the direct refusal of their former general secretary to respect their organization's constitution. According to their constitution, Article 9.4 restricts NATO's Secretary General from participation in partisan politics, which Wubulo East MP Peter Christopher Werike defied. Werike joined partisan politics in 2020, where he was elected as a Member of Parliament for Wubulo West on the National Resistance Movement ticket.
The then Secretary General, after defrauding the organization, together with the Treasurer General, have manipulated their deputies and they want to run away from the organization.
After winning the election, Werike is said to have refused to step down as the General Secretary of NATO in respect to the organization's constitution, which he personally participated in drafting. Addressing the journalists at NATO offices in Chaliwajala, Wakiso District, the organization's chairperson, Asha Wilson Owere, said they were shocked to see Werike still holding onto office, yet his joining politics automatically disqualified him.
He has been telling us that he's going, but he doesn't go. He tells you, I'm now leaving, prepare somebody, then he doesn't go. At the same time, he has conspired with the deputies, and the deputies are not ready to take up the position. So that means he had a senator plan. Even in when we were here in Abba, he came, told the general public that now he has stepped down. Shortly when he was addressing the press, he says he's not going anywhere. So that is, we no longer believe in him.
The union's Secretary General, Henry Mukasa, says Werike should step down.
The reason as to why they ring fence the office of the Secretary is because you're a uniting factor. So the reason as to why we have that provision in the Constitution, for purposes of solidarity and also to unite all of us, and it's only limited to the office of the Secretary General. And it's not limited that no, he shouldn't participate. If at all is to go and participate, then he has to seek leave, which Werike did, and then he came back. But at the same time, we have a clause that requires him to be here 24/7, full time. I mean, we're asking ourselves, you cannot be in Wubulo at the same time be in NATO. So this is the reason as to why we've been asking him politely and kindly that, look, you're doing us a disservice. You don't have time to serve the trade union leaders, to serve the workers of this country. Can you at least step aside? So it was after several pressure that he succumbed and said, okay, let me step down.